let me tell you about pigs. So I was working construction and we were doing concrete with the concrete guy was there for a week or two.
Yeah.
And he lived in the hill towns of Massachusetts. And he said, every Wednesday I slaughter pigs. Come on up. So we went up to his farm, me and my cousin and my buddy. And he had a hunchback as his assistant. So we would go in the barn and they would shoot a pig and the hunchback would run in and slit the pig's throat. And then all the other pigs would run in and start drinking the hot blood pouring out of it while it was still alive. So that's why we call cops pigs, because they don't give a fuck. As their buddy's bleeding out, the other pigs run in there to drink the warm blood. And then we had to get out of there because we were drinking all the hunchbacks, Budweiser's, and he was getting pissed. So we were like, we better get out of here.
That's a crazy story, bro. That's nuts.
Well, that's Western Mass. It's like Deliverance, deep in the woods. And then we went in this big barn, and there was a couple pigs in there the size of this van. There was 3,000-pound pigs in there with tusks and stuff.
That's crazy.
Beasts. So the moral of the story is, I don't know. What is the moral of the story?
I don't know, man. I would have fainted.
Why'd you break down? Why'd the pigs thing make you break down?
The story made me cry because I didn't realize how intelligent these pigs are, but how emotional they are.
Oh, yeah.
And how they have so much feeling.
Animal Farm, great book.
Yeah, it's been a while since I read that one. I haven't read that since high school. But what I'm saying is, you know, animals have feelings, they have emotions.
So you're gonna go vegetarian? That's why you're eating all the grilled cheeses.
Well, I am still a meat eater. But I think I can get behind talking about animals being emotional and having feelings and that we shouldn't.
And they don't hide their feelings.
Animals.
They live truthfully, don't they?
Yeah. They're authentic.
A lot of acting lessons to learn from the animals.
Yeah.
You're right. They're authentic. Touche. Touche, touche.
It's very hard being out. It's not that easy being authentic. It's not as easy as
you
think. Sometimes I feel like I'm authentic and I slip in and out of it.
Right.
It's really...
Be true to yourself. Easier said than done. G-Wagons are the new Prius.
I heard an interesting woman talking on YouTube last night.
Gross, yeah.
Saying it's more of a turn-on to her.
Yeah.
This is about something else, but about authenticity. When guys just say what they feel,
right.
And they just come from like a real emotion.
Oh, yeah.
And they don't try to be anything, and just if they just said what they
wanted. Maybe truth is more rare than we think.
Yeah. I've done really well in my life when I'm in my authentic state. I think I've done better.
Well, we all have.
I've done better.
But we live true to ourselves.
Yeah. But sometimes I don't take advantage of it.
Well, that's what life's all about. Learning to get more and more in the game.
Because I should have been more in the game yesterday. A woman was with two friends, and she kept shaking her butt on the beach, shaking. And I never commented. I should have just said, oh, you caught my attention, but I didn't say anything. But she kept doing it.
Right, and it
was like, that was a moment
to
say something, and she would have been okay.
It was an opening.
Yeah.
Well,
and I don't like
when
I miss opportunities or not respond to certain opportunities.
Right. Well, then start living more. Start putting yourself out there more. De Niro it. Have no fear. No fear of rejection.
I think the reason you have to De Niro every moment of your life or really be in the moment, because you got to take advantage of as many moments as you can.
You got it. Hey, guys, this is just for this place, these tables. All right? There's a bunch of tables in the parking lot over there if you want. All right. Thank you, guys. Well, you got it. Life will fly by, dude. Life will fly by, you know. I mean, which is all right, but you can't be afraid of rejection, which is good because all the women's stuff is similar to Hollywood. Can't I fear rejection? One yes is worth 100 no's or something, you know?
Yeah.
So
exactly.
That's what we're all learning. The artist has to be fearless.